here to tell you about sickle cell disease, an illness that affects over 100,000 people right here in the United States, and millions more around the world. The first thing you need to know is that you can't catch sickle cell. It's caused by a genetic change that is passed down from your parents. If a mom and dad both have that changed gene, then the child has a chance of being born with sickle cell disease. Now, let's talk about what sickle cell can do to your body. These are red blood cells. More specifically, these are healthy red blood cells. These little guys are what carry oxygen all around your body to places that need it, like your heart, your brain, and your lungs. See how round these red blood cells are? That shape and the fact that they're super flexible allows them to move through the body without any holdups. That's good. People who live with sickle cell disease do have healthy round red blood cells, but they also have abnormal red blood cells that look like this, a little different and not as round. See that? It kind of looks like a banana, or what they call sickle shape. So, the big question is, why do some red blood cells sickle? It starts with something called hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the part of the red blood cell that carries oxygen. People with sickle cell have a type of hemoglobin that doesn't carry oxygen as well. After sickled hemoglobin releases oxygen, it clumps together in a stiff rod inside the red blood cell. This causes the red blood cell to become sickled, or banana-shaped. That whole process is called polymerization, and is what changes the shape of the red blood cell. Sickled red blood cells are very fragile. This causes them to break down more easily than healthy red blood cells. Picture a jelly donut exploding. Everything is released from the red blood cell, and the entire thing breaks apart. This is called hemolysis. Because the sickled cells break down, there are less and less red blood cells in the body to carry oxygen. When there are too few red blood cells carrying oxygen, it can lead to something called anemia, which can make people weak and tired. This breakdown of red blood cells can damage the cells lining the blood vessels, causing them to constrict or narrow. This is called endothelial dysfunction, and it can lead to an increased immune response called inflammation, which is very painful. When those sickled red blood cells break down, one of the things that is released is a substance called bilirubin. Too much bilirubin can cause the eyes and skin to turn yellow, which is called jaundice. And since sickled red cells are stiff and sticky and don't move freely, they can pile up and block blood flow inside your blood vessels. It's like a traffic jam and can keep the healthy red blood cells carrying oxygen from getting where they need to go. When those banana-shaped red blood cells get stuck in the tiny blood vessels, it can also cause a lot of pain. In the joints and bones, in the chest and stomach, it's called a pain crisis, or an even bigger word, vaso-occlusion, VOCs for short. A pain crisis can last a few hours. It can last days. And it can be so bad that a person with sickle cell may even need to go to the hospital. All of this, the red blood cells bursting, the low number of healthy cells, and the traffic jams in the blood vessels means that less oxygen is delivered to the body, and that can do a lot of damage to important parts of the body, like the bones, organs, and tissues. They all need oxygen to do their jobs and keep you feeling your best. So now you know what sickle cell is and what happens in the body when cells sickle. Sickling happens every day. The traffic jams, the lack of oxygen, they cause damage even when there isn't any pain. That's why people living with sickle cell are warriors. Some of the strongest, most courageous people walking on planet Earth today. They want to live their best lives, and I'm here to cheer them on.
Sickle Cell Speaks is sponsored by Pfizer.